पहले मैं माननीय प्रधानमंत्री श्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी का संदेश जो उन्होंने विश्व हिंदी दिवस के लिए दिया है, मैं आपको पढ़ के सुनाना चाहूँगा। विदेश मंत्रालय और विदेश स्थित भारतीय मिशनों और केंद्रों द्वारा हर वर्ष 10 जनवरी को विश्व हिंदी दिवस का आयोजन किया जाना अत्यंत हर्ष का विषय है। मुझे खुशी है कि 10 जनवरी 2020 को इस अवसर पर विभिन्न कार्यक्रमों का आयोजन किया जा रहा है। विश्व हिंदी में सर्वाधिक बोली जाने वाली भाषाओं में से एक है। विश्व पटल पर भारत की साख बढ़ाने के साथ ही विदेशों में हिंदी के प्रति सम्मान और रुझान बढ़ा है। हिंदी की भूमिका आज केवल संचार और साहित्य की भाषा तक सीमित नहीं है, बल्कि ये विज्ञान एवं प्रौद्योगिकी, सूचना क्रांति और विकास की भाषा बनने की ओर अग्रसर है। भाषा की सरलता और सहजता उसे अमूल्य बनाती है। हम भाग्यशाली हैं कि हमारे देश में भाषाओं का अनमोल खजाना है। हिंदी इन भाषाओं को जोड़ने में सूत्रधार का काम कर सकती है। विश्व भर में हिंदी का प्रचार प्रसार निर्बाध रूप से जारी रहे, इसी विश्वास के साथ विश्व हिंदी दिवस के उपलक्ष्य पर आयोजित किए जा रहे विभिन्न कार्यक्रम को के लिए मेरी शुभकामनाएं। डियर गेस्ट्स एंड फ्रेंड्स ऑफ इंडिया, इट्स माय इमेंस प्लेजर टू ऑनर एंड ऑनर टू वेलकम यू ऑल टू द सेलिब्रेशंस ऑफ प्रवासी भारतीय दिवस एंड विश्व हिंदी दिवस by the embassy in Djibouti. I just want to say that you have seen some excerpts of the program being conducted by the Ministry of External Affairs in India with 6 missions, where there is a sizable Indian community and Indian origin community. And this is happening just to repose faith of India among the people of Indian origin and NRI community that Government of India is always stand by them. As you are all aware that Pravasi Bharatiya Divas started in 2003 with the Prime Minister, late Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee decided that why not we have a kind of a event in which we associate ourselves with our own people who left India long back, and also our NRI community who are working in different parts of the world, to bring them on one platform and try to know about them, know their problems, then find out solutions of their problems, what kind of life they are living and how much they are associated with India. So that was the idea in 2000 when the Prime Minister late Prime Minister decided, and 2003 it started first time in New Delhi. And why we celebrate on 9th January? Because on 9th January 1915, Mahatma Gandhi returned from South Africa to India on this very day of 9th January. Today he came, it's about 115 years, he came to India after a successful satyagraha and struggle against colonialism in South Africa. He came to India and he is the greatest Pravasi. That's why to commemorate the day, we celebrate 9th January as Pravasi Bharatiya Divas. Now this day, the Pravasi Bharatiya Divas connects with about 17.5 million strong overseas Indian community, which is the largest in the world. The Indian diaspora is the big asset and a source of strength for India. The celebration also is a recognition and also our acknowledgement that India values the contribution of our people who are spread all over the world. It also provides opportunity for us to know, to interact, to network with them, to understand their problems, their issues, and try to find appropriate solutions of those problems and situations. The diaspora has contributed immensely in India's development. For instance, our diaspora is the biggest contributor of remittances, and it is about say $79 billion now. It's a huge amount, $79 billion. It's continuously rising, and that's the money. It's a very big amount, and that is useful for the India's development. It is nicely used by the government of India and the people in the development efforts of the country. NRIs and our PIOs, people of Indian origin, the overseas citizens of India, now they are called, they play an important role of building the India's image. It's not only the ambassador or his staff build the India's image abroad, it is all our Indian brothers and sisters and our OCI community. They are also our ambassador, I would say, in all respect, that to help build India's image and also build the bridges of friendship with the local community. In Djibouti, we know that our community is not big. One ambassador was saying that he has about 7.5 lakh Indian community living in Qatar. We have maybe 750 or maybe 1,000 Indian community, which is quite small number. And but slowly, I am very confident that it will grow. As our embassy is established here, I am more confident that slowly this number will keep rising. And I would say that the friends of Djibouti, that Djibouti is a wonderful place. It's a small country, but a very open heart people. It's a big heart people here. Tolerant nature is there. Being Islamic country, it still is very, very tolerant here. The ethos of peace, respect of plurality, cultural ethos, accepting everybody. That's very, very unique. I found in Djibouti that they are they welcome all the people from anywhere of the world. You see all around, we are people from different countries living peacefully in this country. So that is one very important noticeable feature of Djibouti, how nicely they integrate with the different communities of the world. The government of India also acknowledges the importance of our community here and doing their level best to improve their well-being back in India, also making different policies for the community who are spread all over, so that their family, they live in comfort. The OCI citizens, OCI card is now for lifelong for the people who take this OCI card from us. That is a lifelong card. It has many facilities except voting rights and buying of agricultural land. Rest, you have all the facility on OCI card, that you can invest in India, your children can study, you have good medical facilities at the comparable with NRIs. So it is a big contribution from the government side, but it's not the only one. Many other policies, so it's a dynamic thing. Policies are being made, which is making the life of our OCI and NRIs all of too comfortable in their country, their adopted country, and back in India when they go back to India. Also, I'm glad that in Djibouti, though the number is less, but they have earned a good name of India here. In my meetings with the different ministers here, they always very warmly talk about the Indian community here. So they always say that Indian community is a very peaceful community, which is